Hello everyone, now we will see one question that is from the isometric view. We have to draw the cube of side 40. Now whenever we have to draw the 3D object, 3D object means it will have now the three dimensions. So what is a cube? We can draw the freehand sketch. This shape will be cube. Now this cube, we have side 40 means all sides will be 40, right? So if I divide the cube into three parts, it will have base, surface and top. So what is the base of the cube? A square. We know how to draw the square. It will be side 40 by 40. Height is also 40 and the top, it is again a square. So surface by surface, layer by layer, we will draw the diagram. So first we know we have to draw the isometric axis. We will draw the isometric axis, very light line, mark the point. After that you have to take 30-30 both side. I told you whenever we have to draw the isometric diagrams, take care about each and every 1 mm, 1 degree, it will affect dimensions your diagram. So this is the point for 30 90, and then again 30. So now I have taken very light line. I can give the name OX with open arrowhead because I can extend the line. The size of this line is not fixed, that is why with open arrowhead. Similarly on this side, OY, very light line, open arrowhead, and this side OZ. So this is known as isometric axis. So they can ask you the question separately for this also. So this is the point O, this angle is standard 30 degree. In theory I have explained each and everything why this angle is 30, right? Now the base of this cube is 40 by 40, so I will take a square first, 40, because base is a square, and the same 40 I will take on OY. So here 40, 40 on this side also. Then this point, box method, opposite equal length. So it means from here also I need an intersection point only, so that is why I'm not making a dark here, a big arc or dark arc. So you get the point. Now you have to join it with the 40 point on OY, but very light. All these are the construction lines. Later on we will see which part will be dark, and you are not allowed to erase any of the construction line. This is required. It will show you how we are making the diagram. So this is the base of cube 40. Now we will take height 40. So from four corners of the square, we will directly take height 40 in upward direction. So this is the point, and you can make it vertically like this. Same on the side, try to take exactly vertical line parallel to the axis. The grid sheet which I have suggested you to take, it will help you a lot in making the vertical, exact vertical lines. So here also you will mark 40. So you got this point, and from this corner also exactly 40. So we get 4 points in vertical direction. Now we will join these top points. Again I'm telling you, always draw the light diagram first. Later on we will decide which part should be dark, which part should be light. So always first draw the light diagram. So this is the diagram of a cube. Now we will make the dark portion, which part will be visible. Just try to see if our object is there and you want to see this. You cannot see the rear edges of the cube. So it means what I have to dark. Done. After that, Now in this diagram, why I have not made this line and this line dark? Just try to imagine a solid object. A solid part is there, these rear edges, these three edges, it will not be visible, only this will be the visible part. So now we will do the dimensioning. It is having three dimensions. First, extension line parallel to OY. Same here, extension line parallel to OY. Then dimension line parallel to object line, 10 mm gap, exit, align system, thin arrowhead 3:1. So this is the side 40 as given in the question. So here I have taken the base. Now you can take the height also. So what I'll do for height, you can take in this side also. This is OX. So extension line must be parallel to any of the axes. It's not compulsory to take a particular axis. It can be parallel to any of the axes. Like here I have taken it parallel to OX and it might be parallel to OY. So this is just your way. But only the thing is that it should be parallel to any of the axes. So this is height 40. Right, so this is the way to give the height of the diagram. Now in this we can make a square here, a symbol. Square symbol means a box. It will represent the base is square, 40 by 40, or I can write SQ, it represent 40 by 40, or I can give the dimension here also, three dimensions, length, height. This is length, height and width on this side. I can give that also, or I can make symbol like this 40, or I can make SQ 40. It is representing the same, and this is a square base 40 and height is also 40. So this is the cube, and below that we can give the name to the diagram. This is isometric view. We can mention this because we have two things, isometric view or projection. You can mention this is the view. You have drawn the diagram with the actual given dimensions.